Hello everyone. Am I audible and visible to you? Please confirm. Okay, so let me introduce myself first. Myself, Dr. Sheetal Pipalia, your faculty for physiology. Welcome to the platform of Unacademy. Welcome to the platform of Unacademy, that is Unacademy Future Doctors. Okay, here we will teach you various subjects of MBBS. Okay, so we will explain the subject in a simplified way so you can grasp the content in a better way, which will help you to perform better in your exams. I did MD Physiology from MP Shah Medical College, Jamnagar, and I am educating MBBS and MD students. I have teaching experience of more than 17 years, and I am one of the experienced faculty for integrated curriculum teaching. Let us go through some subscription detail of Unacademy. With the plus subscription, you will have access to both live as well as recorded classes. You can learn from the topmost educator of India. You can compete in live tests and quizzes. You can study on the device of your own choice. You can have access to the question bank having more than 25,000 questions in it. You can even have a printed notes which are available with certain subscriptions. Then Iconic subscription. With Iconic subscription, you will have access to two platforms, Unacademy as well as Prepletter. Both are having unique resources. Like with Unacademy, there are well-structured live batches, there are recorded classes, question bank, competition in live tests and quizzes, comprehensive printed and digital notes. With Prepletter, you will find clinical and integrated essentials, video lectures from Dream Team, question bank with active guidance, rapid revision and snapshot, Treasure and 2021 Dream Notes. So both are unique in its own way. Whatever is best suitable for you, that you can choose. Then special class features. Now Unacademy introduced a special class feature. Now what is this special class feature? Here you will have a interactive live classes. So you can attend the live class, you can participate in live chat and get your doubt clear there only. Okay, there is a feature of creating a poll. Okay, so you can understand the topic in a better way. You can raise the hand while attending the class. You can communicate with the educator and get your doubts solved that time only. You can never miss a class because Unacademy will give you notification about the class. You will have a lecture notes anytime, anywhere. You can attend the live class. Okay, you can participate in the live chat and you will get the doubts solved that time only. Okay, so these are the features with the special class features. Okay, there are updated and highly effective questions. You can focus on the FMG 2022. There is a comprehensive batch, or you can target for NEET PG 2022. There is a test and discussion batch. There is a NEET PG comeback. Now there are 45 questions. You attend it in 60 minutes, and there is a scholarship. Get the additional discount. Now, how to prepare for physiology? To prepare the physiology, you can attend the live classes with me. You can make notes while preparing, while attending the class. Okay. You can even have a printed notes available with the certain subscription. You can even refer books which are available in the market. Now, come to the today's topic, that is a spinal cord lesion. What happens when there is a lesion in the spinal cord? Let us understand first types of the spinal cord lesion. What are the types? Complete transection and incomplete transection. Okay. So complete transection means through and through cut. Incomplete means partially some tracts are damaged. Now, what are the causes of complete transection? Complete transection of the spinal cord can occur in gunshot injury, in dislocation of the spine due to occlusion of the blood vessel. There are three stages of the once the spinal cord lesion occurs. First one is a stage of spinal shock. Second one is a stage of reflex activity. If the reflex activity are not gained properly, and then there can be a stage of reflex failure. Let us go through the first one. That is a stage of spinal shock. Okay, understand the word carefully. In physiology, understanding the word will give you knowledge. Okay, half of the knowledge. Spinal shock, it means complete shock, means complete cessation of the all the functions and activity below the level of the transaction immediately after the injury. Okay, so in that case, all the functions will be lost. That is a stage of spinal shock. So here, different motor effect can be paralysis of the muscles below the level of the injury. Okay, whenever the transaction, this is important, whenever the transaction is between cervical and lumbosacral segment, there will be paraplegia. Right, there will be paraplegia. If transaction is below C5, cervical 5, then there will be quadriplegia, or four limbs will be paralyzed. Here two limbs will be paralyzed, paraplegia. Quadriplegia means all four limbs will be paralyzed. There will be loss of the muscle tone. Okay, loss of the muscle tone. There will be flaccid paralysis. This is important, flaccid paralysis. Okay, in exam, it can be asked in such a way that paraplegia can occur when there is an injury in this level of the spinal cord, or quadriplegia can occur at this level of the injury in the spinal cord. Okay. Then there will be areflexia. Understand the word carefully. Areflexia means absence of reflexes. So here, all superficial and deep reflexes will be either they are reduced or they are lost. Okay, either reflexes are decreased or they are lost. Then sensory effect. All the sensations will be lost below the level of the transaction. All the sensations will be lost. Then vasomotor effect. First, let us understand how the innervation, how kind of innervation there is. Sympathetic vasoconstrictor fibers will leave the spinal cord between the T1 thoracic segment 1 to end L2. Okay, T1 and L2. So depending on the site of the lesion, from T1 to L2, vasomotor effect will be produced. If transaction of the cord is below L2 segment, okay, below L2, where sympathetic vasoconstrictor fibers are not there, you can say they are not leaving the spinal cord. Okay, it is between T1 to L2. So no or very little effect in the blood pressure will be seen. Okay, if transaction is at the level of T1 segment, if it is at the level of T1 segment, it will cut all the thoracic sympathetic neurons from the medullary cardiac vagal center, right? Medullary cardiac vagal center. So it will cause arteriolar dilatation, dilatation of the arteries. So there will be fall in blood pressure. So fall in BP will be less marked as the lesion goes down, okay, distal from T1 towards L2, okay, from T1 to L2, as the level of injury goes down, these effect fall in blood pressure, this effect will be less marked. Okay, then there is an absence of movement due to paralysis of the muscles, so it will further retard the circulation. So because of the lesser absent movement of the muscle, venous return will be reduced, right? So decrease in the venous return will be there. Again, you can say there will be fall in blood pressure, because venous return is one of the important determinant of the blood pressure. So it will cause cold and blue extremities. Lesser the circulation, so skin becomes dry and scaly. And because of the absence of the movement, bed sores can be developed. Then what will be the visceral effect? Okay, what are the effects on the viscera? In the urinary bladder, there will be paralysis. Okay, so sphincter vesicae will regain the tone early. So it will cause retention of the urine. So this is important feature, you can say, important feature, that urinary retention will occur. Then rectum will be paralyzed. It will become hypotonic. So here it will cause constipation, accumulation of feces in the rectum. So it will cause constipation. Penis will be flaccid and erection becomes impossible. Lesion at the level of T6. So So all the impulses, if the lesion is at the level of T6, this is important from question point of view, you can say, exam point of view, all the impulses coming from the abdominal viscera will cut off from the brain. So sensation like distension of the viscera and all those will be lost. Okay, so that is the visceral effect. Now, after the stage of spinal cord, there is a stage of reflex activity. Stage of reflex activity. If the person will survive from the stage of spinal cord, then gradually the functions will start getting recovered. Okay, so approximately after 3 week period, depending on the general health of the patient, reflex activity will start coming back. Okay, it will return in the isolated segment of the spinal cord below the level of lesion. So what will happen? First of all, this is important again, important, okay, smooth muscle will regain the functional activity first, okay. So here, reflex evacuation, automatic bladder, reflex defecation will occur, okay. Smooth muscle will regain the functional activity first. Hello, Vishal. I am glad that you are attending the class. Okay, you are from Nepal. Okay, so I'm happy to see you. So understand this, smooth muscle regain the functional activity first. Okay, then sympathetic tone of the blood vessel will be regained. See, in the stage of spinal cord, what happened? There will be dilatation, right? So dilatation, it will cause fall in blood pressure. Now sympathetic gain is there, sympathetic tone is achieved. So how it will be achieved? By the connector cells of the spinal cord, which will begin to act independently of the vasomotor center. So blood pressure will be restored back to normal. Okay, skin circulation will also be improved. Okay, means cutaneous circulation will be improved. So skin will start getting healed. Okay, bed sores, if it is developed, then it will be healed. Okay, skin will start showing the features like sweating again. Okay, so this way, first one, smooth muscle tone is regained, then sympathetic tone of the blood vessel will be regained, then skeletal muscle tone will recover. After 3 to 4 weeks of the stage of spinal shock, it will start recovering, okay, skeletal muscle tone. So here, this is very, very, very important, okay. Paraplegia inflection will occur. Okay, this is important from exam point of view. Tone of the flexor muscle returns first when there is a complete transaction in the stage of reflex activity. When the person starts recovering after the stage of spinal cord, tone of spinal shock, tone of the flexor muscles will return first. Okay, so what will happen? Because the flexors are becomes less hypotonic than extensors, there will be paraplegia inflection. Okay, so that is a typical feature of a complete transection, that the person is recovering, in the stage of recovery. Okay, there is no wasting of the muscle seen, because the muscles, though the muscles are paralyzed for voluntary movement, but constant reflex activity is there. Okay, so now there will be no muscle wasting. Then reflex activity, which begins to return after few weeks of the recovery of the muscle tone. There, first the flexor returns. Okay, so Babinski sign becomes positive. Okay, extensor reflex will come later on. The muscles of bowing on the site of the lesion, that site you can scratch, and it will cause a spasm of the flexor muscles of both the limbs, evacuation of the bladder, profuse sweating. Okay, so this is mass reflex. Mass reflex can be elicited by scratching the skin, depend on the site of the lesion, either the lower limb or anterior abdominal wall. So it will cause a spasm of the flexor muscles of both the limbs, evacuation of the bladder, and profuse sweating below the level of lesion. So the mass reflex is seen in the stage of recovery. Stage of recovery, okay, reflex activities, when the reflex activities are gained in the complete transection of the spinal cord, Okay, so this is all about the stage of reflex activity. Now, if the person's condition, general condition is not good, okay, or and the person is getting deteriorated, in that case, stage of failure will occur. Failure of reflex activity. Okay, now this can happen because of malnutrition, infection, toxemia. So here what will happen? Reflexes, all the reflexes which starts getting recovered, they are difficult to obtain. And mass reflex will disappear. Okay. Thresholds for all reflexes will increase. And muscle will be wasted and it will become flaccid. So that happens when the person is not recovering and continuously deteriorating due to injury in the spinal cord. Now come to the second one. That is incomplete transection. Understand the word carefully. In physiology, understanding the word will give you half knowledge, you can say. Incomplete cord will escape from the injury. Okay. Specifically, vestibulospinal and reticulospinal tract will escape from the injury. So, this tract will reinforce the activity of the extensor motor neurons. So, tone will first appear in the extensor muscles. Okay, it will first appear in the extensor muscles. So, in incomplete transection, there is a paraplegia in extension. Then, the another one is a extensor reflex or a stretch reflex will return first and flexor reflex will appear later. Okay, so different extensor reflexes you can elicit. Okay, now what are these extensor reflexes? First one is a Philipson's reflex. Philipson's reflex, these all are important. All reflexes are important to remember. Philipson's reflex, it refers to the extension of the opposite limb, which is produced by the gentle flexion of one limb. Okay, flexion of one limb will cause extension of the opposite limb. Okay. Gently, when you flex one limb, it will cause extension of the opposite limb. Same way, you can do it on the opposite side also. Okay. So, this will give you a movement like a steps. Okay. So, it produces the steppage movement. Okay. That is Philipson's reflex. Then, the another one is a extensor thrust reflex, also known as a physiological extensor response. Also known as a physiological extensor response. Hello, Sabu. Hello. Okay, I am right now covering incomplete transection of spinal cord. Okay, extensor thrust reflex, different extensor reflexes. Second one is a extensor thrust reflex, also called as a physiological extensor response. How you will elicit it? By pressing the foot upward with the palm of the upper hand in a patient in whom lower limb has been passively flexed and allowed to rest on the bed. Okay, consider this as a foot. If this is the foot, okay, consider this as a lower limb. You partially flex it and allow it to rest. Proximal stimuli on the sole of the foot of one limb will cause the withdrawal reflex of that limb and forceful extension of the opposite limb. If you consider this as a lower limb, okay, in that case, if this is the sole of the foot and if you apply an oxy stimuli anywhere, okay, it will cause withdrawal from the stimuli and forceful extension of the opposite limb. Okay, so that is a crossed extensor reflex and mass reflex. Here, mass reflex will not be elicited. Okay, mass reflex will not be elicited because the controlling effect of brain stem will persist through the motor fibers. So, here mass reflex will not be there. Okay, Sabu, I got your okay. Now come to the stage of reflex failure. Okay. Stage of reflex failure. Here what will happen? If the person is malnourished, okay, or there is a toxemia, Okay, in that case, these reflexes will not develop. Okay, and person will go into the failure. Reflex activity gain will not be there, and person will keep on getting deteriorated. So that is a stage of reflex failure. Okay, now come to the very important topic, that is a Brown-Sequard syndrome. Brown-Sequard syndrome. This is because of the incomplete transaction, hemisection. Half part is cut. Okay, so the once there is a hemisection, the immediate effect of the hemisection, okay, consider this is, if this is the spinal cord, okay, so half is cut, okay, so immediate effect will be same like a stage of spinal shock. Okay, so this is the diagrammatic representation what will happen. Okay, so different tracks, ascending and descending track. If half is cut, then what will happen? See this one. This is dorsal column, right? Fasciculus gracilis and fasciculus cuneatus. They will cross at a higher level. Okay, so these fibers are uncrossed here, right? Then the red one, that is the ventral and lateral spinothalamic tract. Ventral and lateral spinothalamic tract. Okay, and this is crossed pyramidal tract, and this one is direct pyramidal tract. So if there is a cut here, so what will happen? Some fibers, crossed pyramidal fiber tracts are damaged, and crossed pathway, that is ventral and lateral spinothalamic tract, they are carrying sensation from the opposite side of the body. They will get damaged, right? And dorsal column, which are carrying the sensation from the same half, they will get damaged. And direct pyramidal tract will damage, right? So what will happen? Which kind of sensation will be lost on which part? On the opposite side, which senses will be lost? The senses which are carried by the ventral and lateral spinothalamic tract. On the same side of the damage, those senses which are carried by dorsal column, fasciculus gracilis and fasciculus cuneatus, they will be lost. Okay, and there will be damage to the motor fibers. So let us understand first which tract carries which sensation. Fasciculus gracilis and fasciculus cuneatus carries fine touch, tactile localization, tactile discrimination, pressure, vibration sense, proprioception, all these senses are carried on the same side, right? Then ventral and lateral spinothalamic tract. Ventral spinothalamic tract is carrying the sense that is crude touch. Lateral spinothalamic tract carries sensation, pain and temperature. So now let us understand which and deep tendon reflexes are exaggerated, right? This is important. Babinski sign is positive. There will be no muscle wasting. There will be marked fall in blood pressure because of the damage to the descending fibers of vasomotor center. So, whenever there is a damage here, right? This is the side of the damage. So, below the level of the lesion, on the same side, these fibers are carrying dorsal column, which is carrying fasciculus gracilis and fasciculus cuneatus, whatever senses they are carrying, they will be lost, right? Here, this is the damage. So these fiber, crossed fibers are damaged of the ventral and lateral spinothalamic tract. So opposite side, these senses are carried, right? So opposite side will be lost. Opposite side, these senses will be lost, right? So temperature, crude touch, all these will be lost. Okay, pyramidal tract fibers are damaged on the same side. So there will be upper motor neuron type of paralysis. On the opposite side, there is nothing wrong, right? So there is no motor paralysis on the knee, okay? And there will be little or no motor damage, okay? And what will happen above the level of lesion? There will be hyperesthesia, increase in the sensation, hyperesthesia. Okay, so now let us understand this with the regional peculiarities. What will happen with the different kind of the damages? If the hemisection is occurring at the cervical region, there will be pupillary constriction, loss of biceps, triceps, supinator, pronator jerk, okay, if it is at the level of the cervical region. Okay, in that case, there will be pupillary constriction, loss of the deep jerks, okay, bicep, tricep, supinator, pronator, okay. If C4, 5, 6 segments are involved, there may be paralysis of the diaphragm also, okay. And diaphragm is a muscle of inspiration. Now, hemisection at the lumbar region. If the half section occurs at the lumbar region, and if L3, 4 are involved, there will be loss of knee jerk. And some sort of micturition disturbance will occur. Then, hemisection at lumbosacral region. There will be loss of control over sphincters of the urinary bladder and rectum. Okay, so these all are regional peculiarities. So you need to correlate it from the exam point of view also. Like in the questions, if it is asked that there is a lesion in the spinal cord having a loss of the sphincter, okay, control over the sphincters, urinary bladder and rectum, okay. So, there may be the incontinence, okay, you can say. So, in that case, hemisection will occur, it is at the level of the lumbosacral region. Okay, now what is the complication? What can be the possible complications? So, decubitus ulcer, hypercalcemia, hypercalciuria. Hypercalcemia occur because bone loses calcium. Okay, increase in the urinary loss of calcium. Then, stone can happen because prolonged time immobility plus there is a hypercalcemia, hypercalciuria. In the urine, there is a large amount of calcium. So, it can cause stone. Frequent urinary tract infection, septicemia, uremia, coma or death of the individual. So, these all are the complications of the spinal cord lesion. Now, come to the very important applied aspects related to the spinal cord lesion. Okay, so here the important one, that is a syringomyelia. It occurs due to excessive overgrowth of the neuroglial tissue. Overgrowth, glial tissues. Okay, so overgrowth of the neuroglial tissue, which is accompanied by the cavitation in the gray matter around the central canal of the spinal cord. So that is syringomyelia. The another one is a Tabes dorsalis. It is a disease which is caused by syphilis. This is important. It is a disease which is caused by syphilis. Here there is a bilateral degeneration of the posterior nerve roots. Okay. Bilateral degeneration of posterior nerve roots occur. Then deafferentation. Understand the word carefully. Deafferentation. So here there is an injury to the dorsal nerve root. Okay, which will cause loss of the sensory and there loss of the sensory and there will be some sort of motor disturbance. Okay, then disseminated multiple sclerosis. Disseminated, right? So here there is a demyelinating disorder which is widespread. Okay, disseminated. Okay, involves the white matter of the central nervous system. That is disseminated multiple sclerosis. Then subacute combined degeneration of the spinal cord. Here there is a degeneration of the white fibers by combined, right? So it is a degeneration of the white fibers of the dorsal column and lateral column of the spinal cord, which is commonly found with vitamin B12 deficiency. Okay, so it can cause subacute combined degeneration of spinal cord. Okay, so this is all with the spinal cord lesion. Okay, highlighted point here, I would like to highlight certain things which is very, very important to remember. That is paraplegia, when paraplegia can occur, when quadriplegia can occur, transection between cervical and lumbosacral segment causes paraplegia, Transaction below C5 causes quadriplegia. Flaccid paralysis is seen in the stage of spinal shock in the complete transaction of the spinal cord. Then areflexia can occur. Then smooth muscle regains the functional activity first when the reflex activity starts. So automatic evacuation of the bladder and everything will start. Then sympathetic tone of the blood vessel will regain. So at that time, the cutaneous circulation will be improved. So it will start healing. Okay. This is very, very, very important. Paraplegia in flexion. Okay. Paraplegia in flexion. Okay, because the flexor muscle returns first in complete transection of the spinal cord. Whenever the recovery starts, flexor muscles, the tone in the flexor muscles returns first. So that is a paraplegia in flexion. Babinski sign becomes like Philipson's reflex, extensor thrust reflex, crossed extensor reflex, all will be seen. Okay, incomplete transection of spinal cord. Okay, then hemisection of the spinal cord. Here, everything is important in this topic, I can say. Okay, see, this diagram is important to remember, so you can understand what kind of sensations are lost on which side of the body, below the level of the lesion. Okay, so this is important to remember. This table is important as you will have an idea about which senses will be carried by which tract. Okay, fasciculus gracilis and fasciculus cuneatus carries the kinesthetic senses. Okay, fine touch, tactile localization, tactile discrimination, pressure, vibration, proprioception. And ventral and lateral spinothalamic tract. Ventral spinothalamic tract carry crude touch. Lateral spinothalamic tract carry pain and temperature. This is very important to remember. And applied aspect, I would say. Okay, everything related to the applied aspects. So this is all about spinal cord lesion and its overview, quick view. Okay, which we have gone through. Okay, so if you have any question, you can ask me. Okay. Please subscribe Unacademy Future Doctors channel. You can even ask your question in the comment box. If you ask something, I will reply you there. Okay. Please subscribe Unacademy Future Doctors channel and you will help us to reach to more and more number of students. You will also get the crash course of physiology in a small duration of time with us. Okay. Please subscribe our channel and help us to reach to more and more number of students. Keep studying.